Hi there once again, and welcome to another Expresso Mechanic tutorial. And this is the first in a new set of tutorials entitled Python Bytes. These have come about because people have requested some more basic Python tutorials, let's say. So I'm happy to oblige with those. And what I'll do, it will develop into a set of tutorials, as I say, but it will be over time. I won't be doing these on a weekly basis. I'll be doing them sort of when I'm inclined to do them over the course of time. But what we're going to be looking at in this first tutorial is it'll be a Python effector, but what we'll do is just have a basic look at the matrix array and how this actually works. And then we'll look at moving the positions of the clones within the cloner. That's what we're going to be doing with this. So it's pretty simple tutorial, as I say, for people who are not really that conversant with Python and would just like to know about the basics of it. And we'll take it from there. And as you can see, I'm using my shiny new copy of Release 25. So the layout has changed a little bit. So if there's any problems with navigation, you'll have to bear with me on that. But I should be okay. We're only doing simple stuff, so it shouldn't be too much of a problem. But anyway, without further ado, let's see if we can make this happen. The first thing I'm going to do is bring a cube into the scene and change its size to 20 by 20. By 20, not 2200 or 20,220. Thank you. Right, fillet. I'm going to add. Make it. I mean, we've got sliders here now, which is quite nice. You can just move these. So we'll take that down to a single centimeter. And then I'm going to bring in a cloner. So I'll click on there, bring one of those in, and drop my cube into it. Now in my cloner, I've got it set up as a grid array, which is fine. That's what we want, but we want it to be 10 by 10. And we also want the size to be 21 by 0 by 21. And that gives us a bank of clones. Now, at the moment, we have the clones set up as white. Now, I'd like them to be red for the simple reason that I'm going to also be using the indexes to display those, and of course they're white, so they don't show up very well against white. Okay, so that's great. So that's the first little step complete. Moving on from here, I'm going to bring in a Python effector. Now you'd think they would be where the cloner is, but they're not. They're actually under here. So this is where all the effectors are. So we want the Python effector, and here it is. So we bring one of those in, and straight away it's working because I have my cloner selected, so it's being allocated to the cloner. We want it in full control mode, and we will want to open the editor. But before I go there, we've got some layouts up here which have been added, and we have a script layout. And look at this. Fantastic. It actually looks similar to the script layout that I created in Release 24. Maybe Maxon are watching my videos and a pinch my idea. But anyway, let's open the editor and see what we can do. First thing I'm going to do is get rid of the loop, as I always do. And then let's have a little bit of a discussion about the count here and the mar. What are these and what do they do? Okay. Well, the count here, if we come down into here and we say print brackets cnt, so we're going to print this variable and we execute this, and what we'll do, we'll change the console window here to Python. Let's just change that there and execute that. Now we can see that we've got 100, and that's correct because we've got index values ranging from 0 through to 99. So there are 100 clones, and of course it's a 10 by 10 array. So that's correct. So that's all the count variable is. It's just literally gives you the overall number of clones within a cloner. That's what it's for. And it does have its uses. Now mar here, that's the matrix array. And what is a matrix array? Well, it's what you're seeing in front of you here. This is an array of clones. It's a matrix array because each clone has its own matrix. So what exactly is that? Well, if we come down to our hotkey here and click on this, what we're seeing here is actually a matrix. Because a matrix is a collection of vectors. And we've got position vectors, we've got rotation vectors, and we've got scale vectors. And that's what this is. It's a collection of these vectors. And every one of these clones has this associated with it. So that's why it's a matrix array, because it's an array of the matrices of each individual clone. That's why it's described in that way. So what does it allow us to do? Well, many different things. It will allow us to move the clones in any direction in 3D space, make them face in different directions, and also alter the size of them. So let's move on from here and do some very basic work with the position of the clones. I'll just get rid of this. I don't need to print that anymore. So we'll take that away. Just create some space here. We'll forget about the fields and the four. We don't need to worry about those. Right, so how would we go about moving, say, the position of clone zero? Let's just turn this round so that we can see where we are a little bit better and we can see where our indexes are. The indexes are always in the corners. I wish in some ways they're in the middle of the clones, but they're at the corners, so we can't really do much about that. But right, what we can do then, let's just see where we are. So normally when we move things around, it's quite a simple process, isn't it, for making things move around. But what we've got to do here, we've actually got to do a vector to reals, as we sometimes do with an Expresso. And how do we do that? Well, what we need to say is x is equal to ma, and as we're looking at the first clone here, we've got an index value of 0. So in our square brackets that I've just created, I just put 0 in there. That tells the matrix array that we're interested in looking at this cloner, or this clone of the cloner, the first one. And then we can say dot off. And this is for the offset vector. Now, the offset vector is the vector that deals with the position of each of our clones. So that's the all-important one for us to use here. And that's what we're doing here. So we're dealing with the offset vector, and we want dot x, because we're only interested in the x axis for this particular part of our code that makes up our vector to reals. Then we can say y. Now we can give this a value of 20, because what I'm going to do is just make this clone move 20 up in the y axis. So I'm going to give this a value of 20, and then I'm simply going to copy this, paste it in here, and change this to z and off dot z. So what we've just created there is a vector to reals. We've coded a vector to reals. And then what we need to do in order to make this work is to go back the other way and go from reals to vector. And the way we do that is quite simple. What we need to say is ma 0 dot off is equal to c4d dot vector x comma y comma z. It's as simple as that. So we're saying that our overall offset value, because obviously we've broken our offset down into three different components here, that's what we're doing. So our overall offset value is the sum of x, y and z. That's the value that we're producing here. That's what we're going to do. So let's see what happens when we execute this. And straight away, our clone leaps up 20 units, or 20 centimeters in this case, into the air. So that's how you use the matrix array for moving the clones. Now, if we wanted to move all of the clones, we can do that quite simply by using a for loop. And this is where the count variable can be useful to us. So we can say for I in range brackets count, let's just put in range in there, for I in range count, put a colon at the end, indent all of this, and then all we've got to do is replace the zero with I, and execute this. And all of our clones have now moved 20 units into the air, or 20 units along the y-axis. We could, of course, do something more interesting and say y is equal to 20 plus I. Execute that, and now we get a like a stepped value. It's almost similar to the step effector, but it's not quite the same. But yeah, I mean, doing basic calculations like this, you know, very basic stuff, you can start to make things happen. And that's what this is really about. It's just, you know, you make it do whatever you need it to do at any given time, of course. And this is only, as I say, a very brief sort of expose of what goes on here and what you can actually do. But it's designed for people who've just never done it before. That's the whole point, as I said, of this particular set of tutorials. So there you go. That's how you use the matrix array to actually alter the position of clones within a cloner. So I hope this has given you a good insight and that it's been clear and worthwhile doing. And I'm going to bring the tutorial to an end here. So if you have enjoyed this one, please give the video a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, and of course, ring the bell. And wherever you happen to be on social media, then please, please share the video, because all of this good stuff helps to keep the channel going in the right direction. But anyway, that about completes this tutorial. So I'll see you very soon on the next one.